Welcome back to the StreamYard channel. I am Krystal Proffitt, and I'm really excited to be talking about podcasting today. Did you know that you can use your live streams as a podcast? We're going to talk about a few different ways that you can set up your stream on the back end and a few tips that I've learned along the way to make it a little bit easier. But today's video is really geared towards solo podcasters. So I want to make it very clear that if you are doing a solo only podcast, then you can absolutely utilize the tools that StreamYard offers in making it so easy. So let's go to the computer and I'm gonna show you how this is done. So as you can see, I am here in my StreamYard account and I am going to create a brand new broadcast. So I'm gonna go down and click new broadcast and I'm gonna click where I want this episode to be aired. Now, there's a few different decisions that you have to make about where you want to share this episode. Do you want people to watch it in real time? Do you want it to be something that people can watch later whenever the episode actually airs? Or is this a behind the scenes thing that you want to offer maybe paid members of your community or people that are part of a private group online? So once you make those decisions, then I want you to select where you're gonna broadcast to. For this particular example, I'm gonna do my YouTube channel and I'm gonna say test podcast. Oh, if I can spell right, test podcast. And then this is a test. Of course, you could put whatever description you wanna put in here. And I'm gonna list it as unlisted. That way, if I wanted to record my entire podcast episode, but I wanna wait for this video to air and go live when the actual podcast goes live, then I can do that. Or I could go live and just use the audio later. Whichever works best for you, but for today's training, I'm just gonna use unlisted, and then I'm gonna create this broadcast. So for the purposes of today's training, because I'm using my camera to record, I'm not able to actually pull up my video within StreamYard, but that's okay. We can all use our imaginations, right? So I am going to enter the studio. Here's what I can do in the background. While I'm getting everything set up, I can make the decision of, do I want to have the audio music playing for my podcast introduction? Do I want to have the different aspects of segments? Do I have music that needs to play in between different pieces as far as my intro or my outro goes? These are all a few different ways that you can set up your streaming area before you actually go live. So I'm gonna pretend that everything is good to go and I'm gonna come down here and I'm gonna pick, this is actually some of my music that I would use for my podcast. So if I select that and I'm waiting to go live, let me turn that off because it's gonna start playing music. But if I were to go live, what turns out to be is, hey, I already have my music in there and then I can just strip the audio. So I'm gonna go live for a second. Again, this is an unlisted video, so it's okay that you can't see everything that I have in the background. But what would happen is this is being recorded and I'm doing my podcast episode and then I'm gonna show you in a second how you can take the audio down from this podcast that I'm recording here. So now I'm back on the main account page and I'm gonna go into past broadcast. Now you can see I have several different live streams. If I wanted to go in and use any of these for podcast episodes, I could do that. This is the 25-second one that I just recorded, but let's say I want to take this previous training that I did recently and turn it into a solo podcast. I could click the ellipses button, go down to download recording, and then I could decide, well, do I want to have my audio recorded only, or I forgot I had a guest come on. I could do individual recordings, which we're gonna talk about in a future video about interviews. But for this particular episode, I could just download the audio only recordings and use that in my podcast episodes. And before we end today's video, I wanted to share a few more tips about recording a live stream that you intend on turning into a podcast later. If you know that you want to interact with your audience, then I advise you to schedule your live stream beforehand and invite your community to join you. Say, hey, I'm recording a live session, so come ask me whatever questions you have, and you can actually make it where you are engaging with your audience while you're recording this podcast episode. But if you're like, Krystal, I've been doing a lot of live streams by myself already, and I want to turn those into podcast episodes, that's fantastic. You can either tell your audience, these were previously recorded live streams that I did on my YouTube channel or wherever you aired them previously, or you don't have to mention it at all. I know, it's kind of either or. It's totally up to you and how you want to create your content and present it to your audience, but I think that everyone should take advantage of creating an awesome piece of content and then repurposing it and using it in other ways. Thanks for watching today's video. I hope that you learned something about podcasting and streaming and how you can use these two awesome tools together. Make sure you check out other videos that StreamYard has here on this channel and subscribe if you have not already.